Hello friends, welcome to the next class of Clo 3D. Myself Muskan Bansal from Atirunshan. Today we will learn about all the shapes. Let's begin it now. Go to our 2D window after that this option. When you click at this for long time, then more option will be visible to you. Polygon. Let's see by what methods we can create a polygon. Left click here at once, see like this your measurements are showing up. Click like this. And this pink line that show up reflects that our line is straight if you press shift on your keyboard, so your shape will look like this. See? Now it is only move according to the angles. 90, 45. 0, 90, 45, 0. Like this it will rotate, if you release shift and then begin rotating so it will move like this, and whenever you see this pink line it means we are going in straight direction like this. Now we want these line to look similar 7.324. So I'll click here, right click, and we'll write 7.324, and OK. After that we will end our shape by the help of one left click. Our shape is ready. This is our first method to make any shape. See, it is white in color now, which means it's on 3D panel 2 like this. There are various options. Whenever you want you can make polygon by clicking it over, or you can right click instead of left and you will get the option property for making this line like this. It is 19 inches line. We can do mirror creation as well. Let's see how can we do this with the help of Ctrl plus Z. You can undo your steps. Now we will make it from this center line we have here, and we'll click right button. With this right click we will turn on mirror creation. See what will happen. We have option here, local X axis and Y axis. If you want to make any shape or pattern and wish to have symmetry, so you can use this option. So like while making the shape like this it will be mirrored. Assume we this will be the slope and this is armhole depth. This is for our chest area and this is our hip area, and now it is our straight part. Press shift and now they will be straight in this join. It is white now, which means our pattern is ready. Press A if you wish to resize it. While pressing the shift we can resize it. See, you can resize it as much you required. Put it to a side first and we will make with our next tool rectangle tool. I told you the two ways of making a rectangle. Let's see it again once. Either we can drag our mouse while pressing the left button, or we can left click once on screen. After pressing left button we can add measurements, and it measurement will be 5 interval. In it if we wish we can make more rectangle like it. Rectangle or square, whatever shape you want we can make it more, and count you can increase as much you want. And we can decide its angle. Assume we want a degree 45, so these are set at an angle of 45 and the distance between them from center is 7.5 inches. We can change its distance. I write 10 here, so the distance between them from center is changed. See this for now, we won't have the count much. We will have 5. And now OK. Press the select everything and see this. Now we can place it here. Rotate it from here. See. Press shift and now it will move at 45 degree angle. After this we will see our next tool. Ellipse tool. We can even make square. I believe you all knew the shape of ellipse. I press the left button and drag the mouse as well like this. If I press shift it will become a circle. It's all corner have same distance and the radius is perfect. As well as we made a square, we can make an ellipse or circle in similar way. So we will left click here. We have given many options. Diameter, radius, circumference. We can make our circle in any way as we want. Whatever data we have we can make accordingly. If we have diameter width, so we add that, we know its height, then we will add that. Now we have ellipse here, if put in here as well, so we have a circle like this. Go to the radius. If I have the radius like it's 8 or its height is 10, so it's an ellipse again now. Or if I know its circumference, the outer ring, so put that here. 10, 20. Whatever your value is, you can write it here. You can make ellipse as much big as you want, and like we have the options in rectangle, that's intervals. We have similar one here too. For now we will make a circle with circumference 10. After that we have intervals. In this we have 15 inches of interval, and our angle is 90. So just to give you a little idea, we are showing you this, that how we will make it, and okay, so our circles are here. Press it. Now we can drag and drop it. See, after that let's move forward to our next tool, and that is internal polygon tool. The only difference between them is that we have to make it inside the shape. If we want to cut a shape, we can make it with the help of this. Everything is similar, like we made the square or we make it like this. New thing we have here is position. This will help us to align from center or from the outline, so we can add the value to keep it away from center here, and here will be the value for the outline distance, see this. Or if we do this from the center, we will end it here. So it's 10 inches away from center and toward the right side. With this way we can make square, ellipse or circle, we can align anything like this. Pressing OK. Our today's class is finished. We'll see you in next class soon. Don't forget to subscribe to our channel to receive notification for new video. Don't forget to press the bell icon. If you have any issue, you can ask in comments section. Thank you to all of you.